This is Face the Music, a Jeff Lynne's Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast. Episode 178, When I Was a Boy.
When I was a boy, I had a dream all about the things I'd like to be. Soon as I was in my bed, music played inside my head. When I was a boy, I had a dream. When I was a boy, I learned to play. Far into the night and drift away. Don't wanna work on the milk or the bread. Just wanna play my guitar instead. When I was a boy, I had a dream.
What's that song all about?
When I Was a Boy is the first track on Alone in the Universe, the first full E.L.O. album of new music in 14 years. It was released as a digital single on September 25th, 2015, almost 2 months before the album came out. The only person performing on the track other than Jeff Lynne is Steve J. He played tambourine and shakers. In a press release, Jeff Lynne said,
"A good song can make people feel much less alone in the universe. And trying to create one of those songs somehow makes me feel less alone too. My whole life, from being that kid with a dream in Birmingham right until today, proves how much music can do."
In the October 25th, 2015, My Planet Rocks, Jeff said,
"They were so great, those days, because that's kind of what I say in the song, When I Was a Boy. It's like you get your 15 quid a week, and there's nothing to worry about. It's enough to do what you need to do to pay your higher purchase on the guitar and amp. So it was a wonderful thing. And I'd be really happy just doing that forever."
In an October 22nd, 2015, Rolling Stone article written by Andy Green, Jeff said,
"My interest in music grabbed me when I was a boy. I used to go under my bed listening to the Crystal set. There weren't many good stations back then. You only got about an hour of pop music, and that was on a Sunday night. That's what led to the song, which was one of the quickest I've ever written lyrically and musically."
In November 5th, 2015, Jeff's Slate article for Guitar World, Jeff said,
"That song is very meaningful to me, because it contains the actual truths about how I felt about music from when I was little. But it's also a story about any kid growing up wanting to play the guitar. It's not just about me. Anybody could have that story."
In the December 15th, 2015 issue of Red Dirt Report, Andrew W. Griffin wrote,
"When I Was a Boy, a melancholy 70s-style ballad, kicks off Alone in the Universe, and this is the album's first single. Think the Ramones' Do You Remember Rock and Roll Radio, but by, well, Jeff Lynne."
The song was used in the 2016 Super Bowl ads for Hyundai and was covered in March 2017 by A Great Big World.
"You have a dream?"
"Yes, I do."
"Would you like to talk about it?"
"I certainly would."
I'm Eric Paul Johnson.
And I'm Eric Winsenson.
And I first heard this song back when it came out. And after what happened with Zoom, new ELO, I was more like, new ELO. And When I Was a Boy came out and I listened to it and I was, well, there you go. That's Jeff Lynne. Same kind of drums. Nothing really special about him. The tune was kind of, And then that was it. And I came back to it, I don't know, a few weeks later. It's like, I don't know. I guess it's okay. There's worse songs that he's done. And I came back to it a couple more times, and each more time it's like, I like it. You know what? I like it. And I really like this song. I love this song. And I think I understand why I love this song so much. Because it didn't hit me until today. It's pretty much dangerously crossing the line between a Jeff Lynne original and Real Love by the Beatles, not the Doobie Brothers. They both have sort of the same kind of tune.
When I was a boy, I had a dream all about the things I'd like to be.
They have the same sort of musical motion to them. It's pretty much the same kind of song, and I really loved Real Love. I really love this one. And not just for the music. There are some nice whizzits in there that I like.
Windows, I had a dream.
It's nice to get a song written by Jeff Lynne about Jeff Lynne. To get some idea what's in his head. Something about his life. That's what I really like learning about. Because mostly Jeff Lynne's lyrics are just there to rhyme moon, spoon, and jadoon or anything just to carry it through the song. So I like it. I like it a lot. I think the guitar solo is pretty frickin' awesome. And it's really nice after the guitar solo. We're going to end the song here. We're not going to drag this out. We don't need to add any more to it. Leave well enough alone. I like it. I like it a lot.
Yeah, it wasn't that bad. A bit repetitive, but it wasn't as just generic as some of the other stuff he's been doing lately. Mm-hmm. It does have that Beatle-ish tendency to it. At least now I know that Jeff Lynne votes Democrat because he mentions not wanting to work. Just kidding.
Yeah.
I know you can cut that part out. Anyway, sorry, had to go there. Okay, but back to the actual song. There are some parts in it that not only does it do the nostalgia for him being a kid and dreaming about being popular and everything, it includes little snippets, like a little bit of that echoey drum sound that Bev had in places, as well as a few, I don't know if they're real or synth strings in there. I couldn't really tell from the Jeff Lynne database. I'm assuming they're probably synth strings.
Well, the Jeff Lynne database says it's just Jeff Lynne and one guy playing shakers, so I'm guessing these are synth strings.
Right. But there's a little bit of that nostalgia factor there, and you could get really, really cynical and say, hey, he knows he's got an album that is going to disappoint his fans, but I've got this one song, this one song that people are going to like, so, and it's about the times when people liked my band, so let's go ahead and put this as the lead thing and get everybody all excited, and, well, from what I've heard, I'm not exactly looking forward to the rest of this album. And this is the first song on there, which, if this is the best song, you probably should have buried it a bit.
Not open with the strongest and then follow with the rest?
Yeah, that's good if the rest of the stuff is almost as strong.
Mm.
But too many albums I have, and they're usually 70 minutes long. Start with the strong stuff, and 20 minutes in, here's the stuff that we wrote to finish up the album, rather than the stuff I wrote 15 years ago when I first started making the album. And had inspiration.
Right.
And here's something my girlfriend wrote. Here's something the bass player wrote. And, maybe we should figure out where to place this one single that sounds nothing like the rest of it, but is better than the rest of the album, to tell you the truth. I'll throw it at the end. And then we'll add a bonus track of a cover of a Kate Bush song or something. But, yeah, this song is actually... I mean, if I was going to try and promote a new album, this would be the song that I'd put out saying, hey, I recognize my past, I'm happy about it and everything, and here's a little something for the fans. Personally, I'd try and either just say, well, enjoy the single, or try to do a strong album after it, but I take it we're not in for that.
No spoilers. It's not just Jeff writing about himself that I like. It takes work to be able to write something like this and not have it come off sounding like a condescending rock star. No, I don't want to work for the milk and bread. I don't want a job. I wanted to be a musician, and I did. Too bad for you suckers. I don't think it comes off like that at all. I think it's just pretty much Jeff Lynne saying, I did that. I didn't want to do that anymore. I wanted to do music, so I went and I did music, and it really worked out well for me. So, I don't think it comes off as Jeff Lynne being a jerk. You suckers delivering milk. I got out. You didn't. Now, watch me work with the Beatles.
Wonder if he got more women as a musician or as a milkman.
Well, I think he worked in a factory for one day, and that was enough for him to say, screw this, man, I'm out of here. I'm going to go produce the Beatles someday. You guys just watch.
That I can actually kind of sympathize with.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I did one day at Taco Bell, 6.5 hours working the fryer, and I said, I ain't working fast food ever again. This is crap. I quit the next day. And so far, I have never worked at fast food again, and I'd like to keep it that way.
And all current Taco Bell employees are going, they had stuff to cook food with?
Well, it was the mid-80s.
So. Yeah.
Yeah, 1986.
They cooked the food?
Mm-hmm. What's with the thing with rich people romanticizing being poor in those beautiful days when there was no money?
In those beautiful days when there was no money.
Yeah,
I've had no money. I've had no money to the point where I was begging on Facebook, if anybody can help me so I can avoid eviction, that'd be great. And slowly I've been paying those people back. But no, those weren't beautiful days. I do not remember those as beautiful days. Those are days I don't ever, ever want to go back to ever again. I want the beautiful days of being rich. I want the beautiful days of having a house like Jeff Lynne does, instead of this tiny little apartment, a place where I can spread out my Legoland and all that. Those are beautiful days. The days when I was living off of cereal and milk and not sleeping at nights because it's one day closer to rent is due and I've got $5 to my name. Where am I going to come up with $750 in the next day? Yeah, those weren't beautiful days. Those days sucked.
Yes, they did.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing like trying to do the responsible thing and saying, I really need to make sure I do a house payment. Because one of us is unemployed, I can't afford that house payment. So What should I do? Sell some of the stuff that I have so I have a roof over my head. So when you do decide to do the responsible thing, everybody looks at you like you're trying to buy meth.
Yeah.
Why are you selling this? You probably stole this. No, I collected this for 20 years. Yeah, right. You're poor. You're going to buy drugs. I should have bought drugs. I don't know. Maybe looking back, maybe I should have bought drugs. Because at least I would have been able to sit there and zone out on the couch and not care for a few hours.
Yeah, I can see the perk of that.
But instead, I worked overtime and tried to actually support myself and be responsible. And, well, you get nothing but punishment for that type of thing.
Yes. This could divert into a whole thing about what it's like to be poor and what people who do have a steady income are like to people who don't and don't seem to understand that they're doing everything they can to try and get money or even get a job, and yet we're in such a total economic collapse that jobs are extremely hard to find.
Yeah, look, this is back about the 2008 time, yeah.
That's when it all collapsed in on me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, I love the video. I'm a Jeff Lynne fan. I'm an ELO fan. It's nice to see Jeff Lynne's life play out in about, 3 or 4 minutes? It's really cool to see all the references. You get to see young Jeff. I wonder if young Jeff really did have long, curly hair like the little boy does. I can see someone getting beaten up for having their hair like that in the 1950s. I thought it was great that, they really are going to cover. They even got the ELO spaceship. That's cool. And they've got people being ELO in really bad wigs on stage for a second, I thought it was really great that they had the Wilburys in there too. A scene from End of the Line, and even the rocking chair to represent poor Roy Orbison, who bought the farm by that point.
Was that Danny Harrison in the van with him at one point?
I didn't even think of that. That could be, or if Danny might have been playing George in the Traveling Wilburys section. I'll have to look at that closer.
Yeah. I like the song, and if I didn't know better, it would make me buy the album.
Yeah.
This is going to be a lot better than Zoom.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It's... Jesus, here we go.
Right.
Got something to say about when I was a boy, then call the telephone line voicemail.
6238503375. Call now. When I was a boy, I had a dream. When I was a boy.
Was it a hit or was it?
When I Was a Boy was released as a downloadable single on September 25th, 2015, in the US and the UK. In the UK, a physical single was released only as a promo CD with an original run of 50 copies. The song didn't make the charts in either country. The video, produced by Warren Fu, was released on October 27th, 2015.
And here we are with a station break.
A station break is the time we take
to tell you your tune to
WDGY.
Minneapolis, St. Paul.
Back to ELO.
Oh, good old everybody. It's me, that Xanadu guy in the middle of Limbo Land, Arizona. And here's my take on When I Was a Boy. Well, let's see. When we last left with the last Zoom single, I don't remember. As after I bought the album, and after three listens, I blanked out. And I wasn't keeping track of anything related anymore. Then, almost 15 years later, as if I went to sleep only to be nudged by the point of no return, here comes a new one, and that's when I woke up. After the Zoom slaughter, I was surprised by When I Was a Boy. Top of this multi-layered surprise package, it was the fact that it was about something. Jeff's personal life, mainly his childhood, and how his musical life began. Wow. Such a direct topic for such a private person to write a song about. I guess that Hyde Park show really did help him pull the finger out after all. Maudlin opening with repeating chords give way to sincere lyrics and meaningful delivery that drives the chorus upward and onward. Sure, this is one of Jeff's fine touches, but here it evenly kicks into overdrive, and it also drives the soaring dramatic guitar solo. A personal favorite touch is some of that pixie dust sweetening I used to hear on ELO Days of Yore. This must have been Richard Tandy's contribution to the album in general. He's not directly credited here, but his name is under the acknowledgments, certainly suggests this. No complaints here. Sure, the lo-fi 4x4 sound that polluted Zoom is still around, but Jeff finally shakes it off and shakes it up on this track. And it lands nicely. A great opening for the album and this Jeff Lynne's ELO era we're about to enter.
And now, Eric and Eric go under the covers.
It is all fun and games until someone gets herpes.
It's been a long time, but we got a cover version. Somebody remade an ELO song pretty soon after it came out, too. When I Was a Boy was remade by A Great Big World.
When I was a boy, I had a dream. All about the things I'd like to be. As soon as I was in my bed, music played inside my head. was a boy, I had a dream. When I was a boy, I learned to play.
Well, this is definitely a cover of When I Was a Boy.
Yes, it is.
I know we complain a lot about Jeff's 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 drumming. Yeah, well, luckily, Great Big World does us the favor of using a drum machine.
Is there a difference?
Yeah, there is a difference. I mean, I guess there is a little bit of effort to getting in there and actually using snare, a tom, and a cymbal, and a bass. At least putting a little bit of effort into what you're doing, rather than just, okay, turn this on.
And go. Yeah.
And go. Yeah, it's not like it's a Fairlight anymore from the 80s. This is, download the computer program, and there we go. Doesn't take dragging in Alan Parsons to get everything to work. Otherwise, singer's got a good voice on him, but otherwise it's a cover. It doesn't really change anything from the song. And I think, since the song's about Jeff, kind of, I don't know who he's now supposed to be singing about, because he's not Jeff.
No, he's not.
It's like me doing a cover of Jim Carroll's People Who Died.
And he got split in the jugular vein. And Eddie, I miss you more than all the others. And I salute you, brother. All the people who died, died. All my friends are waiting to die.
I don't know any of those people. I did not grow up in Hell's Kitchen in the 1960s. Yeah. I was not a heroin addict in high school. I am not going to cover that song. It was like listening to Skid Row cover Anarchy in the UK.
Oh my God, I'm glad I missed that.
Anarchy for the USA. It's coming sometime, maybe.
Yes, I think that was Skid Row that did that. There was some American band that covered Anarchy in the UK.
It's by Motley Crue. Now back to Winsenson.
You're not in the UK. You couldn't care less if there was anarchy, communism, Rotarianism? I don't know. Well, the UK is pretty good at shooting their own selves in the foot when it comes to economic ideas. Brexit. But,
Oh, boy.
Yeah. But, otherwise, I mean, you could have done Anarchy in Kansas. I don't know if it sounds the same. Even worse, they could have done God Save the Queen.
I suppose.
So, that's the thing, is that this is When I Was a Boy. It's When Jeff Was a Boy. Yeah, I like your idea of covering a newer ELO song, but there's a lot of newer Jeff Lynne ELO songs and other stuff from Zoom and everything that probably you could do an improvement on. And it isn't so personal. Somebody could probably do a nice rip-roaring cover of Easy Money and make it better than it was on Zoom.
Well, ENIAC, who has his own YouTube video channel where he recuperates or creates from the ground up ELO songs, but without vocals, that sound exactly. It's like he just ripped Jeff Lynne from the song, and it's perfect. The instrumental I use in the bonus tracks episodes for Here Is the News, that's an ENIAC song. And you would not know that he built that song from the ground up, because it sounds so much like the one that's on Time. He recently recuperated an ELO song that I just despise so much, Caught in a Trap or In for the Kill, both the same song.
In for the kill, in for the slaughter, in for the thrill of the power game.
And he did an amazeballs version of it. It was a bajillion times better than the one that was done by ELO.
That is their only care. In for the kill, in for the
the slaughter, in for the thrill of the power game.
It is possible to take a weak ELO song and just make it amazeballs. As for A Great Big World, I like it. It's hard for me to say, do I like it more than the other? I don't think it's a competition. I like the ELO version. I like this version. Both versions I would add to my playlist and enjoy when they randomly come up. I know Jeff Lynne said, it is about him, but it doesn't have to be about him. It could be about anybody who's had a dream of being a rock star. And I guess loosely, sure, I can see that. But Jeff wrote it about himself. So if anybody else does it, it's just going to come off as somebody who's thinking or pretending, I'm Jeff Lynne, and this is what I did when I was a boy, and now this is the song I'm doing about when I was a boy. But I like it. It's got its own whizzits in there that are different from the one that were in the ELO version that make it nice.
And
the guitar solo really isn't any different from the one that was in the ELO version. It even sounds the same. It's like they didn't even do anything to try and change that at all. I mean, other than note for note, it has the same exact guitar sound that Jeff used on there, so.
Mm-hmm.
I can't think of it in my head right now. I don't think there were any harmonies behind the guitar solo for the ELO version, but there was on this version, and I really liked it. I thought, well, that's a nice touch to have over the guitar solo. I like it. I'd listen to it again and again and again.
Yeah, well, that's the thing, is that it sounds so much like the other one, it's hard not to like it, because if you like the other one,
yeah,
you really can't hate this one. It's just, they don't do much with it.
But yeah, it's really not all that different, so it's hard to hate something that pretty much sounds like the one that you like, for the like.
Here's another public service.
This is Denise Crosby, Tasha Yar from Star Trek, The Next Generation, and you're listening to Face the Music, an Electric Light Orchestra song by song podcast.
You're listening to the ELO story.
Hi, ELO fans. It's Mike Hudson again with the Song of the Week. And just like Jeff Lynne, when I was a boy, I too had a dream. And my dream was heavily inspired by Jeff Lynne and ELO. When I was about 14 or so, I got the notion to become a musician. And I wanted to be like Jeff, play guitar, sing, write songs, produce albums. Finally, when I was 15, I got my first guitar. A very cheap one that was hard to play, but it was a guitar. Like Jeff, I'm a self-taught, ear-playing musician who does not read or write musical notation. And I've written quite a few songs and produced several albums with my band and a few other local artists. Unlike Jeff, however, I'm completely unknown to almost 100% of the world, and that's not likely to change. I tried to make a living as a musician for a while in my younger days, but quickly realized that wasn't going to happen, and eventually resigned myself to having music as a hobby. But this song, when I was a boy, really hit a resonant chord with me, pun intended. The lyrics hit home with me in many ways, and the lyrics are pretty good at that. I think the song is a very good song and a great opening track for the Alone in the Universe album. Shortly after it came out, I saw people making comparisons of the chord structure with Procol Harum's song A Whiter Shade of Pale. And it is similar, but the melody is completely different and it has a different feel to it. Besides, you can't copyright a chord progression. If you could, there would be a gazillion lawsuits pending in the courts over just about every song that's been written over the last 50 or 100 years. Okay, I'll go ahead and with this song, get all this out of the way. Yes, the last couple of ELO, or rather Jeff Lynne's ELO albums, have had a rather flat, kind of dull sound to them. Not dull in the sense of boring, but dull as in the sense of being like a knife with a dull edge. You read this all the time in the ELO forums. Everyone talking about overcompression, lack of high-end brilliance, and being very mid-rangey. And they are. I don't know why Jeff has these mixed and or mastered like this, but that's the way way it is. The original release of Zoom was similar, but then it was reissued, re-released, remastered, and it was a lot more dynamic. And the other gripe people have is Jeff's lack of involving other musicians on the latest albums. We could go on and on forever about this, and it won't change a thing. Yes, I wish he had a dedicated drummer, and preferably a dedicated bassist as well, although Jeff is quite capable of playing bass. But it'd be nice to have input from others. And of course, we all wish Richard was on all the tracks, but his health precludes this. So what we get is Jeff, with his engineer Steve J occasionally on percussion, and his daughter Laura doing a few backing vocals here and there. On When I Was a Boy, of course, it's Jeff on drums. The drums are pretty basic, but do have some Ringo-like tom fills here and there, so it's not all just straight kick, snare, 4-4 drum beat all the way through the song. But still, I think it would be nice to have someone else helping Jeff with the drums. He could have a different drummer on each track. That'd be fine with me. And yeah, we'd all love for Bev to return, but that's not going to happen. You stand a better chance of winning the lottery or being hit by lightning twice in the same place. Aside from this, my one real gripe with When I Was a Boy is that it just suddenly ends. After the guitar break, he basically sings the title of the song and that's it. In my mind, I keep wanting to hear another iteration of the full chorus here. I don't know, maybe that would sound awkward in actuality, but I don't think so. I think the song screams for one more chorus. I wouldn't go so far as to say When I Was a Boy is the best track on Alone in the Universe, but it's probably one of the top three tracks. I'll get more into this as we progress further into this album. Well, like Horace, it's time for me to go find myself a life. Until next time, Mike Hudson, out.
Well, hey, this is Dr. Troy, and it's time once again for a thought from Troy. Well, here we are, alone in the universe. I have never heard this album before. I listened to it all the way through last week. I'm going to need to listen to it all the way through again a couple of times before I form any conclusions on the album as a whole. But as to the opening track, When I Was a Boy, I think this is the best opening track of the three ELO albums that Jeff has done since Zoom. I like it better than All Right, and I like it better than From Out of Nowhere. It does have a beautiful melody. I love the use of harmonies, even though I'm pretty sure it's Jeff double or triple tracking his vocals, but it still sounds nice. I love Jeff's voice in the song. I don't think he sounded better in a while before that album was released. And I love the way he can hit the high notes at the end of the verses. But having said that, I'm a little disappointed with the song. I don't hate it, but like many of the songs we've been talking about since Zoom, it just kind of leaves me feeling, okay, that's nice, but I wanted more. I mean, I would have liked a few classic ELO touches to the song. I do think it does remind me of 80s ELO. I think this song would have not have been out of place on the Time album. And I also think that if Balance of Power had more tracks like this, it might have been a better album. And one more thing, I was watching the video on YouTube the other day, about the third time I've watched the video. And I do love the video, by the way, especially the final scene where you see Jeff in his late 60s when he recorded this album. And he's sitting down with his guitar and at least it seems that there's some regret in his eyes. And I just had a thought. What if Jeff is playing the protagonist on the El Dorado album in this video, looking back on his life and regretting that he spent his life daydreaming and not fulfilling himself in some other way? I don't know if that's what he intended, but that's what I saw when I watched the video. Anyway, talk to you next week.
Like it, hate it, what does Madeline think?
Today I listened to When I Was a Boy by
Jeff Lynne's Electric Light Orchestra.
Jeff Lynne Electric Light Orchestra. And just so you know, Jeff Lynne, the boy that you used for you whenever you were younger, he He's a cute boy. I don't love him. He's just like the cute way of how he looked is what I'm saying. And if that was actually you when you were a boy, well, that's how I like you. And well, I like the song a lot, Jeff Lynne. And where do you live? I just want to maybe see you in real life because I've never seen an actual real life person that does concerts before. And I thought, why not do it? It would be pretty awesome.
Wow, she liked it!
Face the Music, an Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast, is a production of Radio Trolla Entertainment, Assorted Deli Meats Amalgamated. You can contact us by voicemail at 623-850-3375 or email us at eloftmpodcast@gmail.com. Keep up to date on the show by joining our Facebook group and spread the word by sharing the link or giving us a quick rating on iTunes. You can financially support the podcast at patreon.com/ELOpod. Next week, episode 179, Love and Rain.
ELO is more than just Jeff Lynne. Jeff Lynne. Jeff Lynne. Jeff Lynne!